What's up? It's Finesse. It's Saturday. I'm out here watching these crazy street performers. They're flipping up. They're doing some out of control stunts. So I'm going to watch them do their show and then I'm talking to the main guy, Raymond.
Raymond?
From the Calypso Tumblers, originally from the Calypso Tumblers.
What's the Calypso Tumblers?
Well, the Calypso Tumblers, like, okay, good example, you make it a long story short. Like, I grew up in 4-H in the Caribbean, where you teach kids how to, you know, survive in the real world. So, the Calypso Tumblers, you know, it's like a group of guys that do street shows. And then, at the end of the show, for the grand finale, they go around and collect money. Where they pay their bills, you know. Yes.
How long have you been a street performer for?
All my life.
All your life?
Yes, I tell you, in St. Kitts, it's in the West Indies, Leeward Island, it's 68 square miles, population about 45,000 people. What happened, I grew up as a kid, you know, in the countryside, and I come across some Peace Corps, and I would ask them why would they come to my island and work without getting paid. And they told me, they explained, but I didn't get it. And then someone once one of them told me that when I start traveling, if I start traveling, I would get it easy. Because, like, I used to look out on the, you know, I'm close to the ocean. I used to look out on the Atlantic side and wonder what's over on the Pacific side. No, I'm over here, I know what's on that side. It's crazy, yeah? But yeah, but I've been a street entertainer all my life. I used to go to the beach in Manchang. That's like another village. And, it's like I start doing sloppy backflips and somersault, and that's how things got started for me.
So self-taught?
Yeah, everything is self-taught.
What brought you out to California?
Well, I was living in New York for quite some time. I was there for about 16 years after the World Trade Center, the energy wasn't the same. When I moved to New Orleans, but I was struggling New York and New Orleans. Go to New Orleans in the wintertime, and I go to New York City in the summertime. And then after the hurricane, you know, Katrina, you know, I didn't really feel what happened. Truthfully, we went back and we performed in New Orleans, but then there was another group of guys named Dragon Masters, they're in green, and they don't like us. You know why? Because we're so similar. But you know, as artists, you come across shady people, and they, not all of them, but the main guy in the group, Mike, he's very shady, so he find a way to get the French Quarter to dislike us. So then we came to California, and we've been in Venice for about 7 years.
Oh, okay, cool. Do you guys ever worry about getting injured?
Injured? No, you can't, because like it's like you as a, you know, entertainer on the street, you can't think like getting injured, because nothing would ever happen. You would never get anything done. It's like walking. You practice to walk, and you walk so good, sometimes you don't know you're walking. So that's our, yes, so that's the street mentality. Okay. Most of these guys have, you know, me and my philosophy about life, it's too short, enjoy it to the fullest. So at the same time, and it's a puzzle. So I try to, you know, every week, just survive, keep my head up above water. And if, you know, better things come, you know, I take it. But if not, you know, I still gonna be happy. Thank you.